everyone. Today we're going to talk about division. In math, division means splitting into equal parts or groups. You probably use division a lot in your day-to-day life, even if you don't realize it. Let's imagine there are 12 cookies, and 4 people want to share them. How many cookies should each person get if the cookies are shared equally? To get the answer, you must divide the cookies 4 ways. 12 divided by 4 equals 3. Each person should get 3 cookies. There are 3 different ways to write division problems that you might see in your math work. Don't get confused. All of these ways mean the same thing. The 3 numbers in a division problem each have a special name. The number being divided is called the dividend. The number that the dividend is divided by is called the divisor. And the result of the division is called the quotient. Division is the opposite of multiplication. If you know a multiplication fact, you can figure out some division facts. Let's look at some examples. First, let's look at 15 divided by 3. 15 divided into 3 equal parts is 5. 3 times 5 equals 15, and 15 divided by 3 is 5. You can also divide 15 by 5. 15 divided by 5 is 3. You can see that these 3 numbers will give us 4 related facts. If you can remember one of these facts, it's easy to figure out the answer to the others. Next, let's take 32 divided by 4. If we divide 32 into 4 equal parts, how many are in each group? 8. 32 divided by 4 equals 8. We can double check this and see if it makes sense by taking 8 times 4. 8 times 4 equals 32. So we know that 8 is the right answer to the question, 32 divided by 4. How else could we divide 32? Well, because 32 divided by 4 equals 8, we know that we could divide 32 by 8. 32 divided by 8 equals 4. Remember our related facts? We could also divide 32 into 2 equal groups of 16, or into 16 groups of 2, and those facts are related as well. Let's look at one more problem, 6 divided by 3. If we divide 6 things into 3 equal groups, each group will only have 2 things in it. 6 divided by 3 is 2. We can check that by looking at the related multiplication facts. 3 times what equals 6? 2. 3 times 2 equals 6. So 6 divided by 3 equals 2. We can divide 6 by 2 as well. 6 divided by 2 equals 3. Now what happens if you divide something by 1? Let's try 6 divided by 1. If you have 6 things, and divided them into 1 group, how many are in that group? 6. Any number divided by 1 is the same number you started with. What if we divide a number by itself, like 6 divided by 6? If you divide 6 things into 6 equal groups, how many things are in each group? 1. Anything divided by itself equals 1. Of course, you can check this too by looking at the related facts. I hope this helped you understand how division works. Goodbye till next time!